Hi everyone, it's Tracy Kiernan from stepbysteppainting.net, and in this tutorial I'm going to show you how I painted this Halloween camper painting. I am doing this on an 11 inch by 14 inch sheet of canvas, and I taped the canvas to the table, and I'm going to go ahead and start by drawing a horizon line. So this horizon line is at about the 3.5 inch mark from the bottom of the canvas. So I'm taking my ruler and just making three little dots across the canvas so that I can get my T-square ruler and draw that horizontal line all the way across. So I have paint all over my T-square ruler and I can't use it for measuring anymore. That's why I use the ruler. And so the T-square is nice because you can lay it on the edge of the canvas and get your pretty straight line. Then we're going to paint the sky of this painting. I am going to do the sky in Prussian blue and titanium white. So one is a Liquitex Basics and then the other is a Artist Loft. And I use a lot of titanium white, so I always grab lots of tubes of the Artist Loft one. So I'm also using a 3/4 inch flat wash brush. Dip it in the water and pat it dry and load it into the Prussian blue. So it's important to load your brush in the water first, just to kind of get the paint to flow a little bit better. And we're going to do up and down strokes, but I'm only going to go about halfway down from the top of the sky. And for me, this Prussian blue is not a color that flows very easily, so I had to slightly dip my brush in the water a little bit here and there to get it to flow. It's a very strong, very dark color. For some reason, it's not flowing very well for me. So you're going to continue to paint up and down strokes about a little more than halfway down. And then we're going to blend in some white on the bottom. So it's kind of a unique background from what I usually do. So if you watch a lot of my painting videos, I like to do a background in like two colors, or actually one color plus the white, and I'll have the two colors blend together. But for this, I wanted the sky to be a little bit darker at top and lighter at the bottom. So the attempt was to add a little bit more white at the bottom and blend it up. So it kind of looked almost like an aurora borealis thing going on in the sky. So you want to go ahead and continue to do that all the way across the canvas. So add the blue at the top and blend some white at the bottom. So all I'm doing is I'm just taking the full width of the brush and sort of dragging that white upwards, and it's blending with the blue. You don't need a lot of white on the brush, so don't grab a big chunk of it. Just slightly dip it into the white. Make sure you're using the full width of the brush and just gently dragging up. If for some reason this is just not working out for you, you can always just double load your brush in the blue and the white and do a double load painting technique. Basically, that means you're blending those two colors together all throughout the background and just doing up and down strokes. The reason I'm doing the blue and the white is just to give the sky a pretty color variation versus if it was just solid dark blue. I also wanted to mention that if you don't have Prussian blue, I know that's kind of a unique color. It's a color that Liquitex Basics did not offer before, but now they do. But it may still be hard to find. If you want to use a different color, you can use any kind of dark blue. So ultramarine blue, phthalo blue. If you're using craft paint, you can use navy blue, really any color. And I'm always okay with you changing the colors of my paintings. That's totally fine. So basically you're just doing the same thing all across the canvas. It's okay to add a little bit of water to your brush to let the paint flow a little bit better. Just don't do a big old puddle of water, because then your paint will drip down the canvas and get everywhere. Also, you want to do the best you can to not go underneath the horizon line. I know I did a lot and I kind of had to fix that later when I did my grass area, but try to stay above the horizon line as much as possible. A way around that could be that if you're using painter's tape, you could mark off your horizon line where that tape line is so that it will, you'll have a nice horizontal line when you pull the tape off later. So that's a way around it. And so I'm just gently blending that white up into the blue. It's not going to be perfect everywhere. It just gives a nice little variation of color, and it's actually not the focus of this painting. So the camper is the focus of the painting. We won't really notice if the sky's messed up or anything like that. Adding a little bit more water into my brush here. My blue is actually drying super fast here. But there we go. And that was probably a little bit more water than needed. And I know if my canvas was sitting up vertically, it'd probably drip down a little bit there. But it's not, it's horizontal. And so just painting that white in there, blending it back up. And if you like the look of the stroke still showing, you can keep it that way. But I'm just going to kind of smooth it out a little bit. I know it's just going to end up blending all together anyway. And just kind of wanted to get creative with this sky background, something different than what I have been doing. And so when you're done with the sky, we're going to go ahead and do the grass. We don't have to wait for the sky to dry to go on to the next step. So this is Hooker's Green Hue Permanent. And I'm going to wash all of that blue off. It's actually going to take several... a whole bunch of water to get all that dark blue off. But if you want, you can rinse your water right now, or it's okay if you end up getting a teeny bit of blue in your green. That's okay. So rinse it off the best you can, get a paper towel and blot it dry, and then you're gonna load it into your Hooker's Green. You can see how rich that dark blue is. It's almost like when you water it down completely, it turns into a watercolor. Okay, so I probably should have patted my brush dry a little bit there, because this Hooker's Green tends to be kind of a transparent color. So this is a little bit more watering than needed, but that's okay. So in the grass, we're going to do left and right strokes. So in the sky, we did up and down strokes. This time we're going to do left and right strokes using the full width of the brush. So this whole area down here is going to be solid Hooker's Green Hue Permanent, or dark green. We'll go with that. And later on, I will blend in some white, but for now, let's just fill in this whole area with the green. And you can see that dark blue is going to still show right there, but I'll show you a way that you can fix that if that happened to you as well. So fill the whole area in. And there are some parts of my videos that I like to speed it up a little bit, but we have that handy pause button there for a reason. So press pause when you need to press pause. Don't paint this fast in real life. You'll drive yourself crazy. And then, so here is a trick that we can do. Not only is this gonna give our ground area a little bit more depth, but that white is going to help with coverage of that dark color that was showing through there. So I loaded my brush in the titanium white without even rinsing that green off, and I'm gently blending it at the top so that my green is lighter way in the distance, right under the horizon line. And that white is going to give, it's going to cover that dark, because that white is such an opaque color. And so my horizon line is nice and light, and then I just blend it down gently to the bottom. And you can use the tip of your brush to really kind of define that line, and just gently stroke back and forth to blend it down so that we have a lighter color in the distance and it just gets darker towards the bottom. So when you're done painting your sky and your ground, you need to either take a break or use a hairdryer to dry your painting. So this is my tracer that I have. You may recognize this if you've been following me for 2 years now. I did a camper painting back in 2018, and it's the exact same traceable for this. So this is the drawing that I made for the camper. I drew it on sketch paper. I outlined it with Sharpie, and I uploaded it onto my blog post to make the camper painting tutorial. So this is the same thing. So I'm just taking this, and this I put it into a rendition of a Halloween camper painting. So what I'm doing, this is actually white graphite paper. I love this white graphite paper because it can show up on the dark colors. So the painting is dark and I have a drawing I want to transfer. So the white graphite paper will show up with white lines. If you're watching this from YouTube, I have this traceable linked right into the description. If you're on my website, it should be right there in the tutorial to click and download as a PDF. So you'll just print it on standard size paper and position it towards a little bit towards the left and kind of lined up from the bottom of the canvas. So you can position it differently, but I wanted it more towards the left because I wanted to put a witch cauldron in the lower right part of the painting. The line that's right there in the middle that I'm tracing right now is actually lined up with the horizon line. So if you kind of want to get the exact spacing that I'm using, the bottom line lines up with the horizon line. And the wheel, I think I did like 2 or 3 fingers from the bottom of the canvas. I didn't exactly measure it. It's just the placement is more towards the left because of what I wanted to add to it. And so I'm just tracing all of the lines and all the details on it. So pull your tracer off and reveal the drawing. And we are going to hand draw the rest. So super easy. I'm actually using a white color pencil right here. And I switched to a chalk pencil in a little bit because the white color pencil actually didn't show up. But I traced one of those. If you have a Master's Touch brush cleaner, that's the exact circle I used to trace the moon. And then I just took it and drew the inside crescent part of the moon. And then this is a chalk pencil right here. I'm going to draw the tree. So I started at the bottom with kind of a wide root base, and then it kind of goes narrow in the middle. And then my tree branches are going to branch off into several branches. And I'm going to have that longer branch kind of go over the camper itself. And then in the lower right area, I drew the witch cauldron. So my other painting, there was a little fire pit in this area, and I substituted that for the little cauldron for the Halloween theme. And so down here, my the root base, I actually wanted this to be a little bit lower. So I took this base and kind of extended it down a little bit. The nice thing about these chalk pencils is that they erase right there on the canvas. So not only do you get the thin line, but they erase as well. These are super handy when drawing out your painting design. So next, what we're going to do is paint the camper in. So this is the fun part. I am going to load my palette with Cadmium Orange Hue and sorry for the shaky camera right there, titanium white. When you add orange to your painting, it's not going to have good coverage. At least this one doesn't, because of the dark background, and orange is a see-through color, mostly. A way around this is to mix white into your orange. It'll make it opaque. It will also make it kind of a creamy orange color. If you don't like that, you can do your first coat, the creamy orange color, and then you can do your second coat, more of the solid orange. So if that's more of the color you're going for, you can do it that way. Or you can paint the entire thing white first. It's kind of a long way because then you have to paint it white, wait for it to dry, and then go over it. But you can do it that way too. I guess I call this the lazy way because I'm double loading in the white and the orange to get my coverage. And then I go back over with a second coat of orange because I was going for more of that bright, solid orange color look. And then, so I'm using the 12 bright brush for kind of the larger areas, and then using the round brush to kind of go into some of the smaller areas. There's no right or wrong order of painting this in. So if you wanted to do the wheels first and then do the bottom part first and work your way up, you can do that. This is just the order that I went in. And so right here, I'm just taking the round brush and going around the door. Obviously, I had to paint over the lights and the window, but that's okay because those are super easy shapes that we can always just go back over and paint again. And then try to get your strokes to kind of curve and go in the direction of the shape. So here's my second coat. When I go back over it with more of that solid orange, that's how my camper area right here is going to be more of an orange color and not so much of that creamsicle color. For the bottom area of the camper, I used Dioxazine Purple and Titanium White. And I did the exact same technique of loading the color with the white so that we have good coverage. This purple has pretty good coverage as it is, but because it's a dark color going over kind of that dark green color, adding the little bit of white in there is going to kind of brighten that purple up a bit and give our give it a little bit more popping color contrast against the green. So we're going to do the same thing. We're going to load it in the purple, grab a little bit of white. So maybe, yeah, mix a little bit of white with purple together right there on the palette to make a lighter purple. And then do the bottom part. So just go around your shapes. And these flat brushes are really helpful because you can kind of turn it and get the sharper line shape and then go around whatever shape that you're filling in. And then you can switch to your round brush to get into some of those smaller areas. So I just painted this whole bottom area with that purple and white combination. I want to go quiet here for just a bit while I finish this step. Okay, so I rinsed all that purple off my brush, as you can see. And I'm painting the door with brilliant yellow green and using the 12 bright brush for this. The brilliant yellow green has pretty good coverage. It's a nice opaque color. However, I still found that I needed to add a little bit of white in there to give it a little bit better coverage. I painted the shape first, closest to the trim as possible, but I still kind of left a gap right there where the trim is, and especially like where the purple and the orange meets, there's a little bit of a gap in there. But I went back and did Mars Black for the trim. So when you're ready to do the trim, you can use any color, but I just used black for this. And a number 4 round brush. I recommend slightly watering your black down a bit for flow purposes. It gets that paint to flow a little bit better. When you load that brush, kind of twist your brush to get the paint right there on the tip, and then go ahead and paint your trim. So I have that line that divides that purple and the orange, and then I have the the black that goes around the door as well. And then on the bottom, we have some black trim as well. I did black for the outer part of the tire, still using that number 4 round brush. So just take the black and paint the outer part of the circle. The inner part is more of a gray. So without even rinsing your brush, grab some white and blend it right there on the palette to get sort of a medium color gray. And then go ahead and paint the hitch of this is that same gray color, but also the inner part of the wheel is gray too. Mine ended up grabbing more black from the tire, so it ended up being a little bit darker of a gray, but that's okay. And then I grabbed black again and I did the black right there in the middle. And then I did a quick little touch up on the purple area. There's a little bit of a gap showing through, so I just grabbed that purple and filled the rest in. Alright, next go ahead and completely rinse your brush off and get some fresh water, because we are going to do a really bright yellow color. And we don't want any muddy colors running into our moon. So we're going to do the moon next and pretty much all the yellow things. So the window too. I'm going to load my palette in yellow and white and mix the two together. Kind of the same concept. It's because the yellow is not so opaque. So adding the white in there is going to give it really good coverage. And I'm just going to paint the crescent moon that color. I have some water running down my brush, so getting a paper towel and kind of wiping the ferrule right there so the water doesn't puddle down is super helpful. Always have a paper towel ready next to you. And so I'm just going to paint that in nice and solid. I'm not going to do any blending or any special texture or anything to this moon, so nice solid color. Then we can go in and take that yellow and do our window. Our window is a square shape, so super simple. Just draw it in, more of a rectangle, I guess. Draw it in and fill it in solid. And I know this video is going a little bit fast, so like I said, press the pause when you need to catch up. This next step, I'm going to show you how I painted the tree in. I used Mars Black for the tree, and you can use your 12 Bright for it. You can use your round. You could use both. Whatever you feel most comfortable painting trees and branches with. I'm going to use my 12 Bright here and probably switch to the round brush when I need to paint the smaller brown branches. So I'm going to start at the base. And it helps to slightly water down your Mars Black, so it'll help flow a little bit better. So I'm just going to paint the base of my trunk, and my trunk starts out wider and it gets thinner as you work your way up. And I'm going to switch to my round brush when I get to the branches up here towards the top, because they're thinner and I can use this brown brush to really get these flowy lines. So you want to really the water has a lot to do with getting this paint and these branches to flow and go to a tip. I know a lot of beginner painters really struggle with these branches, but a couple tips I can give is that so your branch starts out kind of thick to start with, and you want to kind of just release pressure on the brush to get your to get your paint to go thinner and kind of flow out to a thinner line. So what I mean by pressure is how hard or soft you're holding the brush. So if you're holding hard, you're pressing harder, getting a thicker line. If you're holding it lighter, you get kind of a soft sort of feathery line. So the branch is all about just kind of releasing the pressure as you flow out to get the tip of the branch. If you want your dark branches to have a little bit of texture or highlight into it, you can do this to it. It's completely optional. And so I'm going to grab some white. So mix a little bit of white into your black on your palette, so kind of a gray, and just add some white lines just to the right part of some of these branches. Maybe a little bit of water to get it to be a little bit more flowy. This just gets it to stand out a little bit better because that sky is so dark, and getting it to kind of grab some light from maybe that moon or from the light from the camper that's shining. Just a little bit extra in there. Again, completely optional. You don't have to do that if it's too challenging or if you don't like that effect. The rest of this painting pretty much is all these little details in it. So I'm gonna grab some black again and do the black frame around the window. I guess the black trim around the window. And then I made the sides of the window kind of curved. But I also did the cauldron next, so still black, so painting the shape in, and later on I did a little bit of highlight on it, but you'll want to wait for that to dry first before doing any kind of highlight on the black. Next, I freshened up some titanium white on my palette, and I'm going to take this white and do some highlights. So make sure whatever area you're doing this on, your paint is dry. So I'm just taking my round brush, and I'm just kind of painting some white sort of lines on the right side of some of these objects. So on the tire, on the upper right part of the camper, on the hitch. And also, I did polka dots, so over on the purple area, all over the purple area actually, I did polka dots, having them kind of scattered and off on the side, maybe different sizes. So you can do other designs too if polka dots are not your thing. I like to do a lot of polka dots for some reason. So when you make them sort of different size circles, it gives it that sort of whimsical Halloween cutesy look. Then we didn't do any stars in the sky. I didn't do any splatter painting stars. I wanted just to kind of hand paint these stars, and sometimes I don't want to do splatter paint and I just want to paint them in dots. Just be careful when you're doing hand painted dots. You want to really hold that brush very lightly, just on the very very tip of the brush to do these dots. Try to make them sort of in clusters, think constellations, but we're not really doing purposeful constellations, but in the stars in the sky are not like geometrically equally spaced apart. They're in clusters, and there's some that are brighter and a little bit larger, some that are very very tiny. And for the fun steam that's coming out of the cauldron, I recommend dry brushing this. So when you load your brush in the white, use your paper towel to wipe off some excess paint. That'll get it to look dry, and just do this wavy line thing coming out of the pot. And then at the bottom of the pot, you can do these little tiny circles to kind of represent bubbles that are boiling up. And if your cauldron is dry, the black part, you can take that white and just kind of do a highlight on the right side. So just a curve, and then a little bit of a horizontal line on the edging of it. So next I'm going to show you how I did that spider web. So find kind of an open branch area. Use the using the four round brush. If you have a smaller brush that you want to use, that's fine, or even a white paint pen. You can do a white paint pen, but I did the lines and the little webbed lines. And then you can do a spider kind of hanging off of it. You can draw the web kind of going, or the web string kind of going to the right. And then your spider. So this black is not going to be a lot of contrast against that dark area. Do the spider black first, so a circle with four legs on each side, and then wait for that to dry, and then you can use the white to kind of highlight it. It'll make your black pop a little bit better. And then I decided to do my handle black instead of white. Then I used the four round and the black to paint the strings for our string lights. Again, if you have a set of Posca pens, they would be excellent for this type of painting because of all those little tiny details. I know that these thin lines are kind of hard to paint sometimes. And so with the white, I'm doing the little circle bulb. So rinse all that black off. Grab your still the four round brush, and then I just did little circles that are right there on the string of those lights. I also did fall leaves in the tree, kind of made the tree area pop a little bit better. So without rinsing my brush, I still had white on my brush after the lights and I didn't rinse off. I'm just grabbing the orange and I'm going to do black, not black, orange little dots all around the tree, just little dots everywhere. I'm going to switch to a number zero round brush, so it's a much smaller round brush for this little spider, just so we can get a face on the spider. I did a face, two eyes and mouth, and I just went over his legs with the white to help him stand out a little bit better. Next, I'm going to show you how I did the shadow underneath the tree and the wheel and everything. Water down your black to a very watercolor consistency. It's going to make it nice and thin. Grab your round brush and paint left and right strokes right under it. So because that paint is so thin, it's going to be super see-through, but it's also going to make that area slightly darker, give it a little bit of shadow. So just under the wheel and the tree and a little bit under the rest of the camper, not too much. And then, so I'm gonna go back to my little round brush, my zero, and do kind of the base of these lights. Super tiny detail. You don't even have to do that. It doesn't make too much of a difference in there. And then I'm gonna do a cat in the window. So I did kind of a upside down sort of oval shape thing. And a circle, and then I did his ears and tail. So this little tiny brush is super helpful for these tiny details, or a Posca paint pen would be perfect for this kind of painting with all those little details. For the bats, I'm actually going to draw them in first with Sharpie. This Sharpie didn't go on very well, but I was able to get the shape of it in first and then go back and paint it in solid. So I draw the bats by drawing kind of the pointy ears first and the head shape, and then I make two curves through the wings, and then I do two kind of webbed bumps underneath the wing, and then the body kind of curve at the bottom, and then paint it in solid with Mars Black. Then when that dries, or if it dries super fast, you can rinse your brush off, grab some white, and do two little dots in there for the bat's eyes. I wanted mine to have two different size eyes, so I had one big and one kind of small. And then I made those wings stand out a little bit better by doing slightly outlining them with white. So not outlining all the way, but just slightly. Gives it a little bit of pop so it stands out against that dark background. The next thing I did was the pumpkins. So the orange with a little bit of white in there to get it to be a little bit more opaque. These are not realistic pumpkins. I just painted the shape. It's kind of a circular shape almost, and it dips down in the middle almost like you're painting a heart, only you're not painting a heart, if that makes sense. So no pointed bottom. It just kind of dips down slightly in the middle because we have that stem in the middle. So do a few pumpkins, kind of space them wherever you want. You can even do a pumpkin topiary if you want to do that. When the orange dries, then you can paint faces on the pumpkins and the stem. I didn't use brown at all in this painting, so you can use, or I used black for the stem, and then I did black for the jack-o'-lantern faces. I'm going to go ahead and dry my orange really quick with the hairdryer. It speeds up the drying process so that I can paint my jack-o'-lantern faces in there and not have to wait completely for it to dry. And then use the really tiny brush for this because it's such a detailed part, or your Sharpie. You can draw the faces with the Sharpie or a paint pen. So you can have fun and do fun different kinds of faces on your jack-o'-lanterns. And then there's so many details in this painting. I tend to go super overboard with details, but you could even add a ghost in there. You could add a witch in the sky. I thought about maybe doing a broom that's sort of leaning against the tree, but I didn't do that. So many fun little Halloween things. You can do a bat in the tree. Lots of ideas to throw out there. So this is lots of fun, lots of details, but super fun and super easy. This is the last Halloween painting I'm releasing for this 2020 season. I'm going to start working on my winter, believe it or not, winter and Christmas designs already. But I'm really excited about working on those, and I can't wait to release new ones for that season. But this is the conclusion, as I add a second coat to my green door. But this is the conclusion of how to paint a Halloween camper painting tutorial. I hope that you enjoyed painting with me, and thanks for watching.